So you guys knew it was coming. When I saw Aguero, Firmino, both available this week, I had to try them out. So I built a new team, dropped in some cheapish informs I could recommend, and obviously the expensive guys up front. Are they worth it? We're going to find out. So if you can leave a like, that'd be much appreciated. If you are needing game codes or anything game related, head over to gsway.com. Use the code FUJI on that site to get a discount on every single order. And let's get into it. The week and lead so far for me has been going all right. 20-3. It's not fantastic, but I'll take that, you know, considering the gameplay has changed from what I'm experiencing anyway, and the matchmaking is harder. I know that I've got to get better at the game. I've noticed that pre-patch, when I was using the 4-2-3-1 formation, I could defend very well, and I was only needing a select few players in the attack to actually create chances because the cams were in the right place at the right time. They've nerfed that formation after the patch, 100%, from what I've seen anyway. So I'm juggling between that formation and the 4-1-2-1-2 just to get things going, because when I do come up against the better players, I need that extra man in the attack to create chances. But then if I use the 4-1-2-1-2, defensively, I'm open, and I was never good pre-patch defending with it. So that's where I'm at right now. I hope that I can get better, and I will do my very best to grind out and just become a better FIFA player. These are the players I wanted to try out though. First one. Aguero, 94 rated player of the month. 5 games, 10 goals, 1 assist. You what now? 4-star, 4-star, high attacking work rates. 5-for-8. And that acceleration. 95 acceleration, which is what I look for. His strength, 85. The jumping, the ball control, composure, dribbling, finishing, shot power. Could he be one of the best strikers on the game that you could go for? I know that I would not unlock the player of the month just because 1.4 million coins is far too expensive when you can get the 93 off the market for 1.1. Doesn't make much sense, but is that a good card to go for if you don't mind wasting coins? We'll find out. Roberto Firmino. I don't see many people use this card, and I don't really understand why, because his team at a group stage, I think it was a team at a group stage, when I had him in a cam position or even as a striker, his long shots were so powerful and accurate, and what he was doing on the ball, I really enjoyed him. So this 87 rated card, I knew that he wasn't going to disappoint, but I wanted to see how much he really improved. 257,000 coins, 5 games, 5 goals, and I moved him in a cam position, so Gabriel Jesus was a striker. Bonaventura, I really brought him in because of the pace, as I'm so used to Hullet, Vieira, offering so much speed in the midfield to track back. I thought, why not? Let's give him a go. 52,000 coins. He's got some decent stats. Nice pace, shot power, long shots. His stand tackle could be a little bit better, but that stamina really came through towards the end of the games. And Kessie, we could have a cheap beast here. 13,000 coins, 6 foot, high work rates. And I know that he isn't going to be that great on the ball going forward, but what he does offer is tracking back, breaking up the play, and supporting your team. 83 stand tackle, good strength, stamina, and decent enough jumping. And I revisited the team of the year card, Bonucci. Bought him on the RTG. Didn't get on with him. I was honest. I could have said, yeah, I enjoyed him to try and drive his price up, but I'm not like that at all. I just didn't enjoy him, so I sold him straight away. Bought him back on this account. I want to see if he's any good, or maybe it was just the time that I was using him. The gameplay could have been poor. I was disappointed, but let's have a look. His stats, unbelievable, but how will he play in game? We've got to go and try him out. So these are the instructions that I was using. Press the back line for these two guys. My cam, I actually told to... Did I tell him to stay forward? See, I balance between the two. Stay forward, and then I allow him to drop back because I like the defensive support. For the two centre mids, stay on the edge of the box for crosses. Stay back while attacking for the CDM, and stay back while attacking. Some games, actually, I switch Kessie and Alan, by the way, just because Alan's offering the medium to high work rates, whereas Kessie is high to high, wanting to support the play. And these are the custom tactics that I was actually tweaking, and I really... Oh, no, 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 hold on a minute. They didn't save. That is what I was using. Towards the end, like in some of the games, I went 3-0 down against a subscriber when I was playing Divisions, and then I switched a few things up, and I felt that these actually offered me quite a bit defensively, and then in the attack, I was comfortable. So if you want to give them a go, if you're thinking, what formation do I want to use? Hopefully that helps your game. Because if I can defend in that 4-1-2-1-2 with those tactics, I'm sure you will be able to as well. Because I'm not a very good defender. But in the attack, we scored some nice goals. Let's go and find out if these players are worth it. The last Sergio Aguero card that I tried, which was the 92, and I even did a video on it, and I was suggesting to you guys that his dribbling, there was something odd with it. I don't know if it was the fact that he didn't have that much agility or it was the overall ball control. He just couldn't turn as quickly as I was wanting him to. Going up 2 ratings to this player of the month, and you would expect some really nice upgrades if you're spending 1.4 million coins on an untradeable card. And I'll be totally honest with you, there is a nice upgrade going on here. The pace, this is what I felt from the card. The acceleration, the strength, and his reactions. All of those 3 key stats have just made him into an absolute beast. Added with the finishing, the guy can score anywhere on the pitch, outside the box, inside the box, and his dribbling feels amazing. I know the gameplay was nice in divisions, and I shouldn't really focus too much on that, because I tend to go on streaks, and then as soon as I go into the weekend league, it's a different story. And I'm really frustrated with that, because if it was based on divisions, I think we would actually be able to get top 100 quite a lot, because it does feel a bit quicker. But the weekend league, I don't know what they do with it. Hopefully they do fix it for FIFA 19 anyway. But Aguero, going back to the card, he destroyed in the first game. I'm surprised that my opponent stayed around. I believe it finished like 7 or 8-0. And Aguero was just scoring for fun, really. And he stayed consistent. It wasn't like in one game he scored a ton of goals. He was just playing very well over the 5 games that I did use him, and I would very much like to get him on the RTG. Would I spend that amount of coins? If he was tradable on the market, I think for how well he played, 1.6, 1.7 million, he is up there with the elite cards that I've used on the game. Really fun, and his dribbling has been fixed. So his team of the season is going to be out of this world. That is someone that I will purchase without a doubt, 100%. So with someone like Firmino offering that support, what Firmino is very good at is the close control on the ball. He does have the dribbling and he executes the roulette very well. I scored a couple of goals using that technique. His finishing is so accurate. Like, I know that it doesn't really suggest that he's going to be that great, but outside the box, his technique, he is, again, like an elite card. So I don't understand why people don't want to use Firmino. I would recommend for 250,000 coins in the CAM position or even as a striker. But I know for me that I would recommend having someone with a little bit more pace so you can work chances off of that. But CAM Firmino is unbelievable. And I would recommend, really, Firmino more than Aguero because you can't go and spend 1.4 million on an untradeable. But Firmino is definitely one of those cards that you need to bring in, try him out, finesse shots outside the box. He's really good. And Bonaventura, he stepped up. Would I say he's foot champs ready? Depending on how good you are. Now, for me, he was all right, but I did feel that at times he felt a little bit weak going into the challenge. His shot was okay. I only scored one with him, and I think that was literally the only shot that I tried. So it went in. I did like Kessié, though. I think he was the better player, and he's, what, 4 ratings lower? Kessié was offering just the strength and that security in the midfield. And at times I was using him as a centre mid and as a CDM. And with a few more players, like better players to support around him, I think he's going to be solid for you. He can get tackles and throw himself about. Going to Bonucci though, he just didn't really cut it again. Like, I know that I was playing alright, but I know that Bonucci just didn't really... I don't know, there's something with him that he just doesn't work. It could be his acceleration, it could be his stand tackles. He just doesn't do anything for me. And for 600,000 coins, you can go and purchase a Benatia or someone that is going to actually outperform a Bonucci. But if you've used the 96 team of the year, let me know what you think of him in the comments. I would love to use him. And this is why it's like a non-biased opinion, because I love Italian players and I would love to get Bonucci on the RTG alongside Rio Ferdinand. But if he's just not performing for me, then it's a waste of coins. And that's... the situation that I'm in right now. But the players that I would recommend for you guys to go and try, if you don't care about coins, Sergio Aguero is your man. He was actually insane. Like, literally one of the best strikers that I've used on the game. Roberto Firmino is class, 100% worth 250,000 coins. Kessié was good. Bonaventura was all right, but again, I think he just feels a little bit cheap at times. But Kessié, with support around him, he's going to be brilliant. So that's where I'm going to end today's video, guys. Hopefully you have enjoyed the clips. And after when this video goes live, I'll be smashing out the weekend league. Pray for me right now. I just want to get into the elites here. I think we'll be able to do that, but we shall see if we can get to Elite One. Thanks ever so much for watching. Drop a like, and I will see you on the next one. Team out. Peace.